Hey, Matt Morris, welcome to the Unemployed Millionaire Show. Hope you have had an amazing 2014. This is coming to the close here, and one of my favorite times of year. Always love finishing up Christmas, spending time with family. And what I get super excited about doing every year is going through a really intensive goal setting process. And so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to link below the video. I'm going to put a link to a more extended version of my goal setting process. But I just wanted to cover a few points here because, you know, your 2015 is the success or failure of your year coming up is going to be largely based on your plan. What is your action plan for the year? What's the goal set? What's your goal setting process? And so I definitely want you to take the time, you know, click the link below, go through the goal setting process. But, you know, here's the deal. If you do not plan your life, you are kind of like a ping pong ball in the ocean. You just float around. And unfortunately, I mean, the reality is most people float around their entire life. Year after year after year after year, they just float around. And if you don't create a plan, if you're not intentional with your life, you're always just going to be stagnant. You know, when you have goals, in fact, I've got mine set up here. I mean, it is multiple pages, as you can see. But, you know, when you have the goals, when you have the action plan, it's fuel. It's what gets you through the waters. It's what gets you to where you want to be. And if I look at my last several years, every year, just about every year, is better than the year before. And if I'm looking back on 2014, man, it was a rocking year. And, you know, I'm just looking at some of the things that I had said. If you go back a year ago and look at some of the things that I had said, a lot of those I checked off. You know, climbed a Mount Kilimanjaro, huge bucket list item for me. One of my goals from a fitness standpoint was to be able to do 100 push-ups. So stayed consistent with that. I got to, you know, achieve that goal. You know, met almost all of our investment goals spot on. You know, fell short of some goals. In fact, I can't ever remember a time where I have achieved every goal that I've set. It's okay to miss some of your goals. Every year I miss some of my goals, and that's okay. But the simple fact that I have the goals, that I have them written down, that I have the action plan for the goal, I'm going to get a lot closer than if I hadn't set the goals at all. And so, you know, looking at, you know, what we did throughout the year, rented an 18,000 square foot home for my wife's 40th birthday, had a bunch of friends that came with us on that trip. It was a 4-story place. 12 rooms, right on the beach, infinity pool, staff of 8 people waiting on us hand and foot. I mean, it was just incredible. One of my goals was to learn how to kite surf. So I went to the Turks and Caicos, which is probably the best place in the world to kite surf. Did kite surfing lessons, and that was an interesting experience. In fact, I recorded a couple videos on that. Went to Belize, took the family there, went to Madrid, went to South Africa, went to Kenya, went to a couple other places in Europe. I mean, just had an absolutely incredible year. And this process, the goal setting process, if you click on the video below and if you go through that, that's something that I've been doing for well over a decade. And if I were to say, what are some of the things that have led to the life that I have, it has been this process that I go through every year. Now, I'm going to make a quick point because, you know, when you go through, you know, I've got not just my goal, I've got the purpose behind the goal. You know, why do I have this as a goal? You know, a lot of my fun goals, climbing Mount Kilimanjaro, is because part of the purpose of my life is to live life vicariously through myself. I don't want to be the kind of person who says, oh, I'm going to live life vicariously through someone else and see them go do big things. I want to do big things. And so, you know, that just when you have the purpose behind the goal, it gives you a level of motivation to actually go out and achieve the goal that would be greater if you don't have the purpose. Okay? So another quick point, and this is what most people do. They'll get super excited, you know, towards the beginning of the year. They set goals. And then come, you know, into February, into March, they've totally forgotten about the goals. And so something that I do my very best to do is every month, around the first of the month or the end of the month, I'm going to reset my goals. I'm going to go through, I'm going to look at the action plan, and I'm going to see what I've actually achieved or what maybe I fell short on. In fact, I've got one of my colleagues here today, and that's one of the things that we're going to be doing is actually going through some of the goal setting as it relates to, you know, my business. And so, don't just set the goals. Don't just get excited now, but every month go through and review your goals. And, you know, the a quote that I heard a long time ago was that, you know, the people who don't set goals work for the people who do set goals. And the reality is, if you're a parent, you know, if you have children, have your children see you set goals and set some goals for your family. One of the goals that I'm super proud of this year is I had a goal at the beginning of the year to have my daughters memorize a set of family values. And now at the end of the year, my daughters know it backwards and forwards. I can say, what's number one? What's number four? What's number six? And so as we're disciplining our kids, rather than just saying go to timeout or taking a toy away or whatever, I can actually have a conversation with them about how what they did was not in alignment with our family values. And so, you know, that's just an example of something that I'm super proud of for the goals. And I think my children are going to be more powerful leaders and more powerful people because of the goal setting process. So don't just set goals for yourself. Don't just set financial goals. You know, I've got my own personal goals as a speaker and author. I've got my goals with my network marketing company. I've got my financial goals, my investment goals. In fact, I've got my specific goal at the end of 2015. I've got the exact goal on how much passive income I will be earning from an investment standpoint. I've got my information product creation goals. I've got learning goals, which is very, very important. Family goals, obviously. Health and fitness goals. And then don't forget about the fun goals. What do you want to do this year that's going to give you some adventure in your life? And then one last thing that is something, if I'm real open, I haven't been super good about this. And it's something I'm getting, I'm committed to being a lot better with, is planning out, you know, where are you going to be at the end of 1 year? Where are you going to be at the end of 3 years, at the end of 5 years, at the end of 10 years? And so I actually took some time over the last couple of days to plan out where I'm going to be over the next 3 years, 5 years, 10 years. What is my life going to look like? Where am I going to be living? What is my lifestyle going to be looking like? How many homes do I own? What kind of contribution am I going to be making with the world? And when I look at my goals, you know, 5 and 10 years out, I mean, there are some big, big things. And I will tell you, I am way more motivated now because I have these 5 and 10 year goals. I'm more motivated to achieve my goals this year because I know if I achieve my goals this year, it's going to get me a lot closer to living that vision for my life 5 to 10 years out. And so that's something I'm going to encourage you to do. It's actually not in the goal setting video that I'm going to link below. So spend a little time and just say, where are you going to be? And when you write out where you're going to be, put it in present tense as if it's already true. So, you know, I earned X amount this year. I own this many homes. I'm earning this much in residual passive income. So take some time to do that. And here's my wish for you. I want this year to be the best year. 2015 should be the best year that you've ever had. I want you to commit to the process. Every single month, review your goals, stay committed, stay focused, and there is nothing that you can't achieve. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you feel like this can add some value to some other people, tag them in the post, share this around. I want to hear some of your goals. I've told you, you know, some things that I want to do. What are some things that you want to do? Let me know in the comments below, and as always, go make life an adventure.